Merging and unmerging cells in Excel are simple yet powerful tools to make your spreadsheets look more polished. Today, I'm going to show you how to master them in under 5 minutes. Hello, and welcome to Productivity Land, the channel where you learn Excel without boring yourself to death. And today, we're diving into merging and unmerging cells. The best way to learn Excel is by doing, so if you want to follow along with me, check the video description below for the link to download the practice sheets I'll be using. All right, let's get started. Imagine you're on Netflix's marketing team and wrapping up a monthly report. It's almost done, but it's missing one last touch: a bold title and a clear subtitle to explain what the report's about. To make your report shine bright like a diamond, we're going to use a few different ways to merge cells in Excel. First, make sure you have the text you need: a title and a subtitle. Type monthly audience report in cell A1 as the title and active user analysis in cell A2 as the subtitle. Now let's explore the three ways to merge cells in Excel. The first method is the basic merge cells option. This option combines multiple cells into one, keeping the text aligned as it was. It's great if you don't need to adjust the text alignment. Start by selecting cells A1, B1, and C1. Then go to the Home tab, click the Merge and Center dropdown, and select Merge Cells. Once you click, the cells will combine into one, and the text will stay left aligned. The second method is Merge Across. This option is perfect for combining cells across multiple rows at once, like when you need a title in the first row and a subtitle in the second one. That's exactly what we need here. Select the ranges A1 to C1 and A2 to C2 at the same time. Then, go to the dropdown and select Merge Across. Once you click, Excel merges the cells in each row separately, keeping the text alignment intact. The third method is Merge and Center. This is the most popular option for titles because it combines the cells and automatically centers the text. Select cells A1, B1, and C1. Go to the dropdown and choose Merge and Center. Once you click, the text is perfectly centered, and the cells merge into one. Looks way better, right? Now, a quick warning. When you merge cells that all have content, Excel only keeps the content from the leftmost cell and deletes the rest. Let me show you what I mean. Type something into cells A2, B2, and C2. Let's say sales, costs, and profits. Then, select those cells and click Merge and Center. You'll get a warning saying only the content from the leftmost cell will be kept. Click OK. As you can see, Excel kept the text from A2 but erased the content from B2 and C2. Keep this in mind if you don't want to lose important information when merging cells. Now let's talk about doing the opposite, unmerging cells. Sometimes you need to adjust your document's formatting or fix a mistake. Unmerging cells is quick and easy. Let me walk you through it. First, select the merged cell. In this case, select cell A1, which we merged earlier. Then, go to the Home tab, click the Merge and Center dropdown, and select Unmerge Cells. Once you click, Excel splits the merged cell back into the original cells. The content stays in the first cell, A1 in this case, while the other cells are left empty. And finally, YouTube thinks you should watch this video or you'll stay an Excel rookie forever. Just kidding, but give it a click and check it out. I promise you'll learn something new. Thanks for tuning in. Here's a forehead kiss for you. Mwah.